Today, we're going to be going over why this clip of Senator Kennedy out of Louisiana is an absolute load of shit, and why this deplorable needs to absolutely kick the can. Anyways, if you liked the video, hit the subscribe button, the like button, comment, you know, all that good stuff. Turn the bell notification down, like, why don't you a little top, you know, little colored in bell, little lines on top. Hit that so you hit all, so you got all my content. But anyways, let's get into the video. You
make you stay. I don't know how to go my way. I don't wanna make you stay. You know when I count my way.
We'll be going over the like I said, the John Kennedy clip. We're gonna see what this old retard has to say. And why he should probably be sent back to the hospice home. Anyways, let's get into it.
Well, we don't have to get the prices down. With all wages going up, I don't think we need to get these prices down. You think it's okay that bacon's up 20% under President Biden? You're a good sport. Go out every day and try to defend Bidenomics. It's like...
Yeah, she gave you an answer. Wait, raise wages. What? Are you not going to accept that as an answer? Because that's not the answer you wanted to hear? How about this then, okay? Instead of asking her... how do we combat the economy? She gave you a good enough answer. Raise wages. So how about this? How about you give an actual rebuttal and say why raising wages won't work, but you don't do that. Why? Because the network that is primarily host you, Fox News, again, let's remind this fucker, is paid off. Their biggest donors are a crackpot conspiracy theorist in the MyPillow guy. You have private insurance, and then you have a whole bunch of, like, just nonsense companies, right? Again, same thing with NBC. Liberty Mutual Progressive, funded by private insurance, funded by the medical, the big pharmaceutical companies, funded by the U.S. government, like CNN, funded by big banks. I'm sorry, these people don't get to moralize when they have a vested interest in literally fucking you, okay? Fucking you like this, like giving you a good one of these, you know, when that's in their vested interest to do that, I'm sorry, you don't get to talk about how good economics would be if you just lower the cost of things. Yeah, and how do you expect to do that? Like, do you expect us to take all the money out of circulation, you absolute dumb shit? Anyways, let's just continue.
And a fungal infection. Bidenomics is really just paying more to live worse, isn't it?
I certainly wouldn't agree with that characterization.
See, don't you love the way he says that? Just that NBC CNN smugness of what? You think it's Bidenomics is gonna get worse? Is it what? You're just paying more to live worse? Is that what this is? Fucking loser, why don't you become a career politician and make millions of dollars off being in politics? Like, what the like, I swear to God, listen to the way Rachel Maddow speaks and then rewatch that clip. I swear to God, they're entirely the same, because they're all paid off by the same groups: private insurance, big pharmaceutical agencies, and big banks. That's all. Done. That is who your money is coming from, okay? The people who hide health research from the general public, the people who want to fuck you so they can make more money off inflation rates and higher interest rates, and the same companies that caused the 2008 financial crisis, by the way, which made tens of millions of people homeless, okay? Third, you're funded off, the third thing you're funded off, the big pharma places who basically make billions of dollars off of misleading you, the people, you, the general public. That is who this guy is funded by. So the biggest apparatuses that are designed to fuck you in the United States, a person who is just trying to get by, and this guy is saying, you know what? Screw wage raises. Like, who needs a wage raise? What? Home prices are skyrocketing? Nah, no way. But anyways, let's get back into this old buffoon. this old albino baboon fucking... Let's continue to spank his bottom bread, shall we?
A fungal infection. Bidenomics is really just paying more to live worse, isn't it?
I certainly wouldn't agree with that characterization. Bidenomics first tried to address the pain that households were experiencing. And as the economy began to recover, and we quickly, of all advanced countries that experienced the pandemic, no country has done better than the United States in quickly having a labor market recovery, resuming growth, and we have the largest real wage increases of any advanced country. And then medium term, Bidenomics is focused on helping middle class families lead better lives, address the problems that they have,
well,
create jobs and areas.
Madam Secretary, because I've only got 5 minutes. Good try. These high prices.
One, everything she's saying is absolutely correct, right? The difference why we are still paying absurd amounts and other countries have, like, basically stabled off is because in the U.S., we have no unions, okay? Like, I'm sorry, anyone who's a conservative fighting for the people and the progressives fighting the evil racist Republicans, I swear to God, none of these people are actually fighting for you, okay? Like, people like Steven Crowder, the Daily Wire people like Hassan, people like Vaush, even Destiny to an extent. Look, I think he's the most reasonable of them, but like, dude, you look at every single metric, like, by every metric, we should be above or at par with all the rest of these countries price-wise. Why aren't we? Because we don't have unions. A lot of these countries have a properly funded public system, where our public system, a lot of the time, is just like, oh, you need public housing built? Okay, we're going to build it at the public level, like the public funding, you know, with taxes and all that. But then we're just going to give it to some massive corporation, right? So, yeah, fuck these people. Anyways, let's continue.
Don't create jobs in here.
Please, Madam Secretary, because I've only got 5 minutes. Good try. These high prices caused by Bidenomics are here to stay, aren't they?
Well, the high prices were not caused by Bidenomics.
But if I could ask you, they're here to stay, aren't they?
I don't expect the level of prices to go down. But the rate of inflation...
So they're here to stay.
Well, some prices will be higher than they were before the pandemic and will stay higher, but wages have risen considerably. Wages are going up.
You don't get a pay raise, you're screwed. I mean, here's what... There's a difference between disinflation and deflation. Y'all talk about disinflation, which I'm happy to have. Disinflation means inflation is going down. It means prices are rising less rapidly than they were. But that's a far cry from deflation, which means the level of these high prices caused by Bidenomics are here to stay. Here's what Jay Powell just said on February 4th. He was asked the question, inflation is one thing, prices are another, and I wonder if there's any reason to believe that people will see the prices of things decline. And here's what Chairman Powell said. So the prices of some things will decline, others will go up, but we don't expect to see a decline in the overall price level. That doesn't tend to happen in economies, except in very negative circumstances. He's talking about a recession. It will take a recession to get these prices down.
Well, we don't have to get the prices down.
We don't?
Wages going up, and a metric...
I swear, don't you love that smugness of, they said prices aren't going to go down? How dare they? It's so disrespectful. What, we shouldn't raise wages to match? We have to go into a recession instead of just raising wages to match the money we have in circulation? Nah, the American people don't deserve that. They just deserve to go through a massive recession even though we could raise wages to match. Like, I swear to God, these people just do... Like, they do not care. The utter contempt they have for you is absolutely absurdly insane. And yeah, people like Steven Crowder say, what if the left had power unfettered? Well, one, first of all, describe me what left means, okay? Describe me what left wing means in general, okay? Describe me that whole thing. Because again, I guarantee you that one, you're gonna look stupid because it's a arbitrary metric, okay? Like, it's insane, like, how this stuff gets described. Two, we had Democrats in House, Senate, President in Biden's, I think, first half of his first term, okay? You know what never happened? Much else at all, actually. They never addressed Medicare. They never addressed any of these things. I believe Bernie Sanders tried to push these things, but at the end of the day, neither party cares about you. This is not even a critique of just, like, people like John Kennedy, Senator Kennedy, right? It's a general thing. They don't care about you. They would rather fist you with a big fist like this than give you a cent more in minimum wage, because they are paid off by these private insurance groups, by big banks, by the pharmaceutical industry. And so why do they care? They're making millions of dollars off these super PACs. Why should they give a fuck about you? Why should they give a solitary shit about how bad your living standards are? Why should they? Like, at some point, you gotta just, like, be like, you know what? Fuck these people. We're gonna give them a big fat middle finger. We're gonna say, yeah, you know what? We're not gonna work. Okay. What you gonna do about it? Like, at some point, you gotta just go, like, okay, I can do Uber Eats, pay for my gas, just, you know, whatever. Right? Because at some point, these people, like, have to stop putting corporate profits over your well-being, over your living standards, over how you use your money. It's ridiculous. The absurdity of these people and their absolute hatred for you is insane to me. It's absurd to me how, it's really bugs the shit out of me, honestly. And that's why I studied this stuff. But anyways, if you want to see more retarded politicians, more paid off polis, anyways, come back in the next video. I try to upload as much as I can. But anyways, talk to you later. Peace.